Now, your News 9 Sports.
The Packers wrapped up their 14th practice of training camp with a very competitive two-minute drill, and that competition has been a big part of training camp thus far. Sports director Brad Hansen has more from Green Bay.
Well, after a sluggish start to practice, the offense and defense battled in a two-minute period. We weren't able to film that portion of practice, but no doubt the intensity level certainly picked up. And that's something we've seen during this training camp. These two units, the offense and defense, going after each other in practice after practice. Aaron Rodgers said today they may have lost the two-minute drill, but he thought they won the day. It's a rare win for the offense this year in what's been a fun camp to watch.
But it's been fun, man. The competition's been great. There's practices, as you guys, I'm sure, are timing them. They're shorter than maybe some we've done in the past, but they're pretty competitive. It's pretty up-tempo.
Yeah, I thought it was pretty competitive out there. You know, there were some challenging looks that Petten was providing. Where our quarterbacks had to do some more things at the line of scrimmage. But I thought it was a good competitive period.
A kind of an interesting moment in camp today. A helicopter was seen circling the practice field. It did it twice. It lingered a little bit longer. Its second time through, head coach Matt LaFleur said, probably just the Bears scouting department. In Green Bay, I'm Brad Hansen, News 9 Sports.
Meanwhile, Aaron Rodgers will be wearing a new helmet in a game for the first time Thursday. His old helmet did not conform to the league's new safety rules. The Raiders' Antonio Brown threatened to retire if he couldn't wear his old helmet. That drama has been resolved. He'll wear a new helmet and report to the Raiders. Rodgers, whose season ended with a concussion in week 17, knew he was headed for a change.
My helmet, because there's been such advancements in helmet safety, my helmet was actually in the not as safe category. But anybody wearing that kind of got one more year to find a new helmet. So, I mean, I knew coming in I was going to have to make a change. There's a connection to a helmet for sure. I love my helmet, every one that I've worn. I don't know that I would want to retire if I couldn't wear my helmet. I mean, I obviously didn't because I'm here today. But I'm sure he can find one eventually that he really likes.
The Packers are now headed on the road for a Thursday night showdown with the Ravens. That's preseason game number 2, and you can catch it right here on News 9, your official Packer station. Well, the Brewers had yesterday off, but are back in action tonight. Their border rivalry with the Minnesota Twins begins with a 2-game series. Both teams 5-5 in the last 10 games. Christian Yelich is back in the Cruz lineup after missing 5 starts. Scoreless until the bottom of the third, Mitch Garver last one to left center field, carries way back and into the Brewers' bullpen. The 2-run homer gives the Twins the lead. Bottom 4, down 3-0. Brewers get the ball rolling. Runners on first and second. Lorenzo Cain knocks the ground ball to short. Just able to beat the double play. Hernan Perez touches home, and the Brewers are on the board for the first time. Bottom 7, Brewers down 4-1. Yelich doesn't take him very long to get back into the swing of things. Rips one to center off the wall. Keston Hira scores, and it's a 2-run game. And Yasmani Grandal puts Milwaukee back in this thing. A monster shot to right. The 3-run homer gives the Brewers the lead. Score right now, though, it's 7-5 Twins in the 8th inning. We'll be right back.